So human pregnancy, we told that the gestation period is actually last 9 months. For cats, 2 months. Dogs also 2 months. But elephants, there is a prolonged period, the gestation period, that is 21 months, you can see that. And what are the main changes, right, during the embryonic development that we have to understand, right? So you can see that after 1 month in the fetus, there will be that a heart formation will be there, right? So the heart will be developed after 1 month, right? In the end of that 2nd month, you can see that there will be small that are digits and limbs, right? They will start developing. You can see that in the correctly, you can see the limbs and that digits also, the finger, right? The digits also will form after the end of the 2nd month, right? So once that now first trimester finished, that means about the 3 months, right? That is the 12 weeks time. You can see there will be development of major organs, jaise ki limbs or the external genital organs, everything that will be very well developed. It started developing the limbs and all, but it will be very well developed, right, at the end of that 12 weeks. That's called first trimester, right? So that's up to the 3 months, right? So mostly in the case of pregnancy, the doctor will suggest a what lay ultrasound scanning at the third month or the first after finishing the first trimester, so that they can understand whether the fetal development is proper or not, right? Now you can see that during the 5th month, right, there will be the first movement of the fetus will appear, or the hair that now on the head, that will also you can you can see that, right? So there will be some movement of the fetus, right? They will start moving, right? And in the same time, you can see that there will be hairs on the head, right? And at the end of 24 weeks, that is the second trimester, that means 6 months, the entire body will cover with fine, small hairs, and the eyelids also that are separate, and there will be eyelashes will be formed in that time, right? So here there will be the movement of the baby will be more visible. The mother can feel that movement of the baby very very clearly, right? At the end of the 9 month, that it's all the total complete growth occurred of that fetus, and it is ready for the delivery, right? Now here you can see that these are some of the pictures of the embryonic development, right? What are the changes is happening? The 1st month, 2nd month, this is 3rd, 4th, 5th, right, 6th, 7th, about complete fetus formation take place. 8th month, yes, it's already completed. Now in the 9th month, that baby, the fetus will be you can see the head down position, because this is the correct position for the delivery. Otherwise it will be really difficult for the baby for a normal delivery. Now the delivery, that's the labor, or it is called parturition, right? The process of giving birth to young ones, that's called the parturition or the labor, right? So these labor actually happening because of the induction by some neuroendocrine mechanism, the nervous system also controlling, and there is a very important role for the hormones also, right? So there will be some signals from the fetus, that's called that actually fetal ejection reflex, right? And the placenta will induce the mild uterine contractions. You can see that there will be some signals from the fetus, right, and the placenta, which will induce the uterine contraction. There will be starting that a mild uterine contraction will start. That's called the fetal ejection reflex. That means once the growth completed, yes, now the baby has to come out, right? So from the fetus, there will be some signals will start. At the same time, you can see some signals from the placenta also. That means it will start inducing that delivery, right? And it will induce the uterine contraction, because we already discussed that the structure of uterus, it's highly, right, muscular in nature, the myometrium, the medium, that not the endometrium, the myometrium, which is highly muscular in nature, right? So if the mild uterine contraction will start, that process is called fetal ejection reflex. That means the fetus has to eject out. So that reflex will start, right? And this will cause the release of oxytocin from the maternal pituitary, right? So if fetal ejection reflex start over here, it will stimulate the pituitary to secrete oxytocin, right? Now you can see that this is the picture. You can see that, right? Yes, here if it is that mild, dire dire, you can see the mother can sense that once the time of delivery, right? So a small uterine contraction will start. They will feel that yes, the uterine is contracting. Regularly there will be in a small interval it will start. Once yes, the time of parturation, the contraction rate will increase. That means the interval will be decreased and the rate of contraction will increase, right? So that means this oxytocin causes the strong uterine muscle contraction, which in turn stimulate the further secretion of oxytocin. That means pehle fetal ejection reflex hoga. Kaise? The fetus will induce aur uske saath saath placenta bhi itna kuch signal send karega, which will cause that myometrium to contract, right? वो थोड़ा सा contraction pituitary को stimulate करकर that will secrete the oxytocin hormone. ये oxytocin hormone it's very important for the contraction of that uterine wall. It will cause the strong uterine muscle contraction, right? फिर वो further more oxytocin को secrete करने के लिए help करती है. And then the contraction will be more strong and that will be continued, right? And I told that already. धीरे धीरे वो contraction के rate बढ़ जाएगा interval. पहले दैट मींस और से हाफ एन आवर में दो टाइम था, फिर हाफ एन आवर में यू कैन सी दैट दैट 5 6 टाइम कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस यू कैन फील दैट नॉट यू एक्चुअली द मदर कैन फील दैट राइट. सो द प्रोसेस एक्चुअली कंटिन्यूड एंड दैट विल बी लीड टू द एक्सपल्शन ऑफ दैट बेबी आउट ऑफ द यूट्रस थ्रू द बर्थ कैनाल. सो द बर्थ कैनाल हियर इज द वजाइना इटसेल्फ राइट. सो यू कैन सी हियर वंस द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन इंक्रीजेस धीरे धीरे द बेबी विल कम आउट ऑफ दैट प्लासेंटा एंड इट विल बी expelled out through the birth canal, right? So here you can see that this is the placenta area, this is the uterus, right? And this will be the umbilical cord. Now the baby has come out, right? But these structures will be remain inside the uterus, so it has to be removed. So you can see that this is the entire placenta and this is the umbilical cord, right? So the baby come out, then that will be that umbilical cord will be cut. So there is no nerves in this umbilical cord, so there will be no pain for the baby, right? So you can see that once the baby come out, the doctors will cut down this umbilical cord, and the same time then they will remove these part also, because it will not come out as such. That means automatically once the baby will come out, these things will be pulled out. It has to be pulled out, then only this umbilical cord any placental part will be come out, right? So here after parturition you can see that the umbilical cord is cut off, right? And the placenta and the remnants of umbilical cord are expelled from the maternal body after parturition. That's called afterbirth. So this entire system then and this things is that actually the afterbirth we can say that. In some cases it will be, most of the cases it will be expelled out, but in some cases there will be some complication. It will be that maybe inside the uterus it can be. So the doctors will be pulled it out. So that from the mother's body, whatever the remnants are there, that will be removed properly. Now, the baby born, right? So already the birth of the baby occurred. Now the baby has to be nourished, right? So first some the now first year the their growth at the 1 year they cannot take any other food because they are actually new to all these things. They can only take the mother's milk, right? Or that's only digestible for them, right? So the mammary gland, right, produce milk towards the end of the pregnancy, right? That will be produced there. That is called the lactation. So what is that? The mammary glands produce milk towards the end of the pregnancy. That's why we discussed about the prolactin hormone, right? The placenta will start producing prolactin. So that's actually helping for the milk production and all. That will be stored in the mammary gland, right? And there will be a yellowish, right, milk, first milk, that is yellow gaada. Pila dood, right? The first yellowish milk that will be produced initial few days of that lactation, that's called colostrum. It's very important because it's that much rich in several antibodies, right? Immunoglobulins, right? And that will be very much essential for the development of that immunity of that baby. That means it will be very much essential to develop resistance for the newborn babies, right? So that's why we are telling the first milk is that much important. It will be a light, slight yellowish in color. You can see this. This is the normal milk, but here you can see this is the first colostrum, which is a yellowish, that means thick milk produced by the mother for the baby because it contains so many immunoglobulin and the antibodies and all. So that will provide resistance for the newborn babies. I hope you understand all the things. Thanks for watching. Thank you.